Good morning to all of you. Today we are going to study the second lesson of our economics, that is the sectors of Indian economy. Okay, this song we'll study the second lesson. In this lesson, first you can see, as you can see in the picture here, the people are doing different activities. Okay, some are doing the cultivation, some are helping, you are doing giving the service. Okay, some are doing work in the consumption level. So different activities the people are doing. So on the basis of the activities that the people are doing, the sectors we can classify into primary sector, secondary sector, and a tertiary sector. Economic activities are classified into groups using some important criteria. These groups are known as the sectors of economy. People around us are engaged in different activities to earn livelihood. Some may be producing goods while others may be delivering the service. Means the activities that the people are doing, that activities we can divide into three categories. Okay, they may be producing some production, yeah, goods, yes, they may be giving some service. So classification of the sectors, that is on the basis of the nature of activity. Based on what kind of activity the people they are doing, the sectors can be divided or classified into primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. Primary, yeah, agricultural and related sector. Secondary sector, also called industrial sector, yeah, manufacturing sector. And tertiary sector, it is called service sector. So first we will study the primary sector. What is primary sector? The economic activities which are connected with the extraction and production of natural resource. For example, agriculture, fishing, mining, all these things falls under the primary sector. Means in the primary sector, the activities are totally depending on the nature. With the help of nature, yeah, from the nature directly we are taking the goods. For example, mining. Mining, you can understand that we are directly taking the minerals from the earth. Yeah, agriculture, directly we are getting the production. Fishing, forestry, okay, then this one, dairy farming, all these thing category, all these activities are known as the primary sector, also known as an agricultural and related sector. Second, it is a secondary sector. The economic activities which are related to the manufacturing process. Manufacturing of steel falls under the secondary sector. Means with the raw materials that are produced in the primary sector, we are manufacturing, yeah, we are making some new productions, goods with the raw materials. That is called the secondary sector. Since there is some procedures, yeah, manufacturing it is taking place. This sector also is called a manufacturing sector. For example, sugar cane we are changing into sugar. It is an example of a secondary sector. Sugar cane, it is a product of primary sector. This sugar cane we are changing into sugar cane. So therefore it is called a secondary sector. Since some it is related to manufacturing, yeah, related to industries, this secondary sector also is called a manufacturing sector, yeah, industrial sector. Third one, it is a tertiary sector. The economic activities that are mostly based on providing services to the society, like transportation, banking, insurance, etc., falls under tertiary sector. Means in the tertiary sector, the goods are not produced, but service is provided. You can see the examples of as it is, you can see here, banking, yeah, transportation, communication, yeah, as I am teaching, the teaching profession, okay, all these things it is coming under the category of tertiary sector, all these activities. Since it is mostly related to the service, this sector also is called a service sector. Now, after studying these three sectors, primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector, we have to see that the three sectors are depending on each other. That means interdependence of sectors. Interdependence of sectors. How the primary sector is depending on the secondary and tertiary sector. How the secondary sector it is depending on other two sectors. They are interdependent on each other. For example, we can take the example of agriculture, primary sector. Now you see that the primary sector, they are produced, the farmers produce the sugar cane. But if the sugar mill, the people who are working in the sugar mill, if they are not ready to take the sugar cane, what do the farmers will do with this sugar cane? Okay, and if they are cultivated something, they cultivate crops and other things, but the people are not, the traders or transporters are not ready to take them to the market. So here we can see how the primary sector is depending on these two. The same is the secondary sector also depending on. For example, if the primary sector is not there, there is no need of making any the secondary sector, then there is no need of making for the tractors, motors, all that things are needed for the modern farming methods you are studied. Okay, different kinds of tools that the farmers are using, different kinds of machines they are using. So all these things, it is made in the secondary sector. It is because of the development in the primary sector. The same way, the tertiary sector, it is developing because of the development of the primary and secondary sector. So it means that all these three sectors are depend on each other.